It sure is, Chris. After an exhausting season filled with suits both for Juventus and Portugal, it's about time the Ronaldos took a break. But where does the man who conquers everywhere he goes actually go to on holiday? Let's find out. CR7. We'll start with right now. After Portugal's exit in the Euros at the hands of Belgium, Cristiano grabbed Georgina, Cristianinho, Eva, Mateo, and Alana Martina and took them down to the sunny Spanish coast. Georgina was set after an exhausting year living the Italian life. The Ronaldos picked Mallorca, particularly the north part of the paradisiac Spanish island. It's the same destination they picked last year, and apart from a luxurious rented villa near the coast of Poyenza, there's another key factor in the mix. A super yacht bought last June, worth over $7.6 million. The Asimut Grande is an 88-foot-long vessel with 5 luxury cabins and 6 bathrooms. It also includes a modern kitchen, 2 relaxation areas, a huge lounge, and a dining room. It has a max speed of 28 knots and every single detail to make your stay at the CR7 perfect. It was bought last year after years of Cristiano renting yachts. How do we know all this, you ask? Well, Georgina was kind enough to share it on Instagram last summer. As for the destination, Mallorca is home to some of the most beautiful beaches in Europe, with crystal clear waters, white sand, and hidden coves aplenty. The French Riviera. Not to be confused with a move to PSG, the closest Cristiano has been to Ligue 1 is the famed French Riviera, also known as the Azure Coast. It's the French side of the Mediterranean coastline and receives over 14 million tourists a year. You've probably heard of Saint-Tropez and Monaco's beauty. Well, the Ronaldos have too. This is also a destination they prefer to visit by sea. Most footballers prefer this yacht-type style of break. You can enjoy more than one destination at the same time while stopping by to swim on the beautiful coasts. And it helps avoid the paparazzi and fans, though some fans have tried their best to get close to them. The beautiful sunsets seal the deal for them, even if Cristiano thinks he can match them. And the cherry on top is the haute cuisine France has to offer, with some of the most lavish and renowned restaurants in the world. This high-end, stylish life is one Cristiano has gotten used to, but in the past, he wasn't as picky. Ibiza. Everyone's heard the stories. If you haven't been there, you still know what goes on. Footballers love Ibiza. The Icardis love it. Messi loves it so much he has hotels there. We wonder why. But if there's one thing Ibiza is known for, it's the partying. And Cristiano used to love an Ibiza party. That doesn't seem to be the case right now. Since meeting Georgina, Ibiza holidays are a thing of the past. They have moved to a higher level. Dubai. Dubai is another hot destination for footballers at the top level. It's even become a regular place for them to go in the mid-season, escaping the European winter. As much as Cristiano loves Dubai, Dubai loves Cristiano back. Whenever he's in town, he's there to relax but also pick up awards. Whoever said you can't mix business and pleasure obviously didn't have Cristiano Ronaldo in mind. Cristiano has a very close friendship with Hamdan bin Mohammed Al Maktoum, the Crown Prince of Dubai. So much so, he's been granted a 10-year UAE gold visa, which makes Cristiano a lawful resident of the Emirates. And Georgina, well, Georgina is there for the views. No place like home. Sure, who doesn't love to travel the world, meet new places, eat at great restaurants, and try new things? But in the end, there's nothing like getting back to where you belong. And for Cristiano Ronaldo, that's Portugal. Be it at his hometown of Madeira or the cosmopolitan Lisbon, Cristiano makes sure that he gets back to his country every so often. That's the reason why he invests so much in hotels there. And he's even bought one of the most luxurious apartments in Portugal's capital. Who can blame him? Lisbon is a perfect city, a mix of tradition and modernity. Could Cristiano's next Portuguese holiday be extended with a contract at his boyhood club? Only time will tell. For now, we should let the man enjoy his well-deserved break from football until the 2021-2022 season is ready to go.